I got an interesting comment from a student in my orgasmic vegetables class. Yep, that's really the name of the class. He said that he tried roasting butternut squash using my video. That's before he took the class. And it never had a nicely browned stage the way the video showed. It was pale for a long time and then turned black. Any ideas as to what might have caused this problem? I use a lot of oil when I roast veggies. I mean, at least a quarter cup for a half sheet. And for some vegetables, like roasted cabbage wedges, even more. When that student saw me roasting the veggies in class, he was shocked. I use just as much oil in my videos and I give explicit measurements for them, but I'm guessing most people think they can reduce the oil without compromising the results. I have gotten every possible reaction in my veggies class when people watch me with the olive oil bottle. I've had jaws dropping. I've had people whispering helpful advice to each other along the lines of, "You really don't need that much oil. I roast my veggies with just one tablespoon." Look, to each their own. But this got me thinking, what exactly happens when you use less and less oil? So I set up a little experiment. I cut up a crazy amount of butternut squash and roasted with four different amounts of oil. Here are the basics of my experimental setup. For each test, I used 600 grams of squash on a quarter sheet sprinkled with 2.5 grams of salt. The oven temperature was set to 400 Fahrenheit, which was probably closer to 425 because my oven runs hot, but it was the same for all the cookie sheets. Each cookie sheet went into the oven all alone so that the positioning in the oven was the same. For 600 grams of squash, I normally use 28 grams of oil. So for this experiment, I did it with 7, 14, 21, and 28 grams. As a proper scientific experiment, this was a complete failure for a few reasons. Every piece in a cookie sheet browns differently. The center browns the least and the outside browns the most. So doing any fair comparison of color was very difficult. There was even a difference between the outer pieces, somewhat darker than others. So how would you make sure that you're comparing apples to apples? I don't know. It was also hard to show you in the video the textural differences. It's not just how dark the pieces are, it's whether they are developing sticky, caramelly sort of browning or charred sort of browning. Then there was the problem of when to stir them. Do I stir them when they achieved the kind of browning I like, or do I stir them all at the same time? So after trying this, I realized that I don't know how to set up a proper experiment for this to give you good quantitative data. But it's hard to spend the entire day roasting squash and not learn something. So here's what I've learned. And keep in mind that this is somewhat subjective. There wasn't much difference between 21 and 28 grams of oil. Both were delicious and both produced slightly sticky, nicely caramelized browning. Even 14 grams of oil wasn't too bad, but more pieces tasted a little burnt versus caramelized. And with only 7 grams, pretty much all browning tasted either wimpy or burnt. A very interesting thing for me was how exactly do you apply this oil? Normally, I put the veggies on the baking sheet and drizzle them with oil and toss them right on the sheet. But for this experiment, I used a bowl to toss the veggies before pouring them onto a baking dish. I think that's how you're supposed to do it, but I never do. If you're very generous with oil, it's not that hard to distribute it evenly. But the less oil you use, the harder it is to spread it out over every surface of every piece. And that's where the bowl comes in. It helps you give your veggies a good toss. That's probably why 14 grams of oil was better than I expected. My problem with the bowl is that I don't want to wash it, and some veggies like big pieces of cabbage will fall apart if you try to toss them. But there are many cases where a bowl would help. So if you're reducing the oil at all in any of my recipes, at least use a bowl and don't go lower than 2 to 3 tablespoons per half sheet. In case you're wondering, I would use 4. Another thing to keep in mind is that not all vegetables will react the same way to the reduction of oil, because some have more sugars, some have more water, so there is no one amount that will work for everything. Because you can't ruin vegetables with too much oil, but you can easily ruin them with not enough oil. I just go to town with it. If you want to try my kind of roasted vegetables, here is how to develop your intuition for how much oil to use. Don't worry, we're not going to dirty any measuring spoons or cups to create any extra dishes for you to wash. And you won't even need a bowl. Take the cap off your olive oil bottle, set the bottle on the scale and press the tear button to get to zero. Pour some oil all over your veggies and put the bottle back on the scale. Keep doing that until you get to negative 56 grams for a half sheet. By volume, that's a quarter cup, and that's how much oil I'd use. I know most of you think you don't need it, but try it once and see if you like the results. Depending on how many veggies you have on the cookie sheet and depending on the vegetable type, some of the soil might not be absorbed after you are done roasting. If that happens, tilt the cookie sheet for the excess oil to drip out. You could refrigerate this leftover oil and reuse it. I'm sure a question will come up about which oil I use. I use cheap extra virgin olive oil. The exact brand varies, but at the moment it's 365 brand from Whole Foods. This one is supposed to be Spanish, but they sell them from Greece, Portugal, Italy, etc. I haven't tried them all, but out of the ones I have tried, Spanish was my favorite. I don't like very aggressive or bitter oils, so I like this one because it's mild, but you can use anything you want. I tried using non-extra virgin olive oil for roasting, and the veggies had less flavor. So I do prefer extra virgin. But I also don't use my finest oil for this. I think it would be a waste of money on a cooked dish. Save that for your salads or other dishes where the oil won't be heated. May your oil flow freely, and may your vegetables be delicious. Here are more thought-provoking videos for you to check out. And if you are ever in the Boston area, maybe I'll see you in one of my classes.